All right, in the second sessions of our Grains to Glass series, we're going to be looking at ingredients. This is really exciting. We're going to take a look at grains, hops, water, and yeast to really take a look at how your beer can taste better. So in this episode, we're actually looking at grains first and how to make a grain tea. We're going to look at four different base malts: two row, Pilsen, Vienna, and Golden Promise.
Welcome back to Grains and Glass. This is our second series of many, I hope, and we're going to be looking at brewing in a different way this time. We're going to be focusing on ingredients. I get this question all the time. What's the difference in base malts? What's the difference in hops? What's the difference in yeast? What do they taste? What do they make the taste like? That's what we're really going to focus on. We're going to look at how to look at ingredients from a different perspective, from the nose to the mouth, and isolate each one of them. How to do that? First, we're gonna look at our ingredient grains. We're gonna make some grain teas. Then we're gonna look at hops. No, we're just not gonna pop some pellets in our mouth and hopefully burn the back of our throat. We're actually gonna make a hop tea on that and get some aroma and some flavor off of it. Then we're gonna actually go a little bit deeper into the science behind it and actually look at your water profiles, how to get your water profiles into Beersmith so you can actually adjust it for whatever kind of beer flavor you want. And last, we're gonna split batch a simple pale ale, hoppy, but a lot of fun. It's not going to be I would say a smash recipe. But we're gonna take a 5 gallon batch, split it up into four different containers, and we're going to have four different omega yeast. I think you're gonna really enjoy this. Stick with us, and here we go. Cheers. So what we're gonna do is make a grain tea. And a grain tea is basically a simple mash with a small amount of grain and a little bit of water. Now I'm gonna do it a little bit different because I'm getting ready for our homebrew club, which meets the third Thursday of each month from 7 to 9 here at Schoolhouse. So we're gonna have about 20 or 30 brewers here, and we're gonna actually taste all the different grains. Now, at home, what you wanna do is put about 4 ounces of water to 1.5 ounces of grain at 170 degree water for 30 minutes. Steep it, then you can taste it. I like to use a small hop sack to do it. These are really convenient because you can actually just steep them. It's kind of like doing brewing a bag inside the water. The grains that we're gonna be looking at today are, okay, so now what I've done is taken the grains out of the bags and put them in muslin sacks. Once again, you do not need to do this. You are going to be doing 4 ounces of water to 1.5 ounces of grain at 170 degrees for about 30 minutes. So what I'll do next is actually put the water on here and steep it for 30 minutes.
The first grain we're going to be looking at is two row brewer's malt. The second is Pilsner malt, also known as Pilsen. The next is the German Vienna malt. And lastly, we are looking at the British Golden Promise, very similar to Maris Otter.
So after 30 minutes, we're done. All you have to do is taste each one. But if you notice, each one of them has different properties right off the bat. If you could smell them right now, you could definitely see it, but you can also see just how much different the color is. All right, some descriptions of each of the malts. Two row is a base malt made from two row barley with typical features of plump kernels and a high starch and protein ratio. Light color is about 1.83 Lovenbond. Now, we move to Pilsen. Pilsner malt is a base malt is the lightest color available. It's got about a 1 degree of Lovenbond. It works light beers, ales, you see them a lot of lagers and such. One of the things you definitely need to know about Pilsen malt is that you want to boil this for 90 minutes. Now, Vienna. Vienna is another steep step above pale malts. It's about a 3.5 to 4.5 Lovenbond, which it's good option for Vienna lagers, Oktoberfest, maybe some brown ales that you like to do to get that real backbone to it. And then we have Golden Promise. Golden Promise is very similar to Maris Otter, and I really do love this grain. When you're looking for a well-balanced malt complement with big hops, this is the one I like to go to. This or Maris Otter gives a great mouthfeel. It's lightly malted. It's about a 2.5, so it's a great way if you're trying to get away from crystal malts but still have some color to your IPAs. This is one that you might want to look at. So that's how you make your hop teas. As for flavor, there's really no way for me to tell you about it. The only way to do it is actually make some, smell some, and taste some. Now, the next one we're going to be doing is hop teas. So that's how you make your grain teas. As for the taste, there's only one way to do it, is to make them on your own. Then smell them on your own, taste them on your own. In our next video, we're going to be looking at hop teas, to actually look at some hops that I really like, and then we'll go from there. Please subscribe, watch our other videos. We've got some great ones to do. As always, cheers.